Well, here we are with Chris Rehm on the top of the La Concha Hotel in beautiful Key West, Florida. How you doing, Chris?
Fabulous. I mean, what more could you ask? We've got the whole top of La Concha to ourselves today. A big thanks to Michelle Granger, who is the one who actually inspired us doing the interview. So thanks, Michelle. We appreciate it.
We were doing this interview from the roof of La Concha in beautiful Key West, Florida, because we want to know about your upcoming album.
That's correct. Yeah, it's going to be Shanghai'd, Marooned in Key West. Things could be worse.
And this is a true story, actually, because you are Shanghai'd and Marooned in Key West.
I Shanghai'd myself to Key West. Yes, you're right.
So you're doing an album focused entirely on the Keys and the Conch Republic. Is that true?
That's correct, yeah. All of the songs are one way or another, not necessarily connected at all, but they're all about the Keys, living in the Keys, doing things in the Keys, people in the Keys. Again, not necessarily connected, but that's what it's all about.
So give us some of the titles of the songs.
Well, we have Mile Zero.
That's a good one.
That's one of the songs we're going to be doing. Then we have The South is North of Here.
Also a true story.
That's a true story. It was inspired by the Nashville songwriters who came down, and they all kept saying, well, it's so great to be playing in the South, and we're all saying, this isn't the South. I mean, you're not going to find biscuits and gravy in this town.
Are the songs all intertwined as a common expanding story?
No. No, they're all just separate stories, all focused on things that happened in the Keys or things I've experienced in the Keys. Not necessarily, but the thing they do have in common is that they're all from the Keys. Mostly Key West.
So that's why it's called Shanghai'd
and Marooned
in Key West.
Things could be worse. Key West is a pretty good place to be Shanghai'd to.
And regarding the album that's coming out, recorded by Danny Simpson of Privateer Studios.
Yeah,
he's
Dan's
a virtual
just,
genius.
Oh, I was kind of intimidated because I'd heard so many things about Dan. And within 3 seconds after I met him, he and I were laughing our heads off together. He's a really, really easygoing guy. On the same token, he's a phenomenal engineer.
And very serious about his work.
He is, but he's having fun when he does it.
Besides Danny Simpson and yourself, who else is going to be involved in the album?
We're going to have Jackson Bunn on keyboards. I'm not sure which keyboards we're going to have him on because of time. We'll probably also have Chris Flowers on keyboards. I've already talked to him. And then we're looking at Din Allen, we're hoping to have on bass, and Richard Crooks, who's played with everyone from David Bromberg to Bob Dylan, he'll be on the drums. We're going to have Caffeine Carl on a few songs. Well, looks like we're going to be able to get my old buddy from Miami, Albert Castilla. He'll play guitar on a few, and Bobby DeVito will probably play on a song or
Bobby
two.
Bobby D.
Yeah, yeah. So those are some.
So you're going to have some yourself and a bunch of other amazing guitar players helping to translate your music to the human family.
That's correct. Oh, and Mike Emerson's going to be on
Mike Emerson,
jazz guitar player.
Another amazing
here. He's
going to
be
guitar.
On. Yeah. A song that I did, which is a jazzy song.
So it looks like you got everybody but Bill Blue on the album.
Well, you never know. I might get Bill Blue to sing. I think I mentioned to you back a couple of years ago when we did the demo, I said, you know, Bill Blue would be a great song to great guy to sing Mile Zero.
Mile Zero, yeah. So is there anything we should expect that would set this album apart from all the rest?
Well, I can't say exactly what it is, but I'm trying to bring album art back to albums. Back, you know, when I was younger, we had the 12-inch vinyl records, and they had these beautiful, big 12-inch vinyl albums, and art was a very big thing then for the albums. And then when they went to CDs, you know, it was much more compact, and the sleeve you'd pull out, and it was all folded, and it was glossy, and it, over the years, it kind of lost the impact of album art, and I have an idea of a way to kind of bring that back, which we're going to try to do on this one.
Shanghai'd and Marooned in Key West.
Things could be worse.
There it is.
That's it.
I actually remember the name of the album.
Yeah, Danny, worked with Danny last summer, and as a matter of fact, the 3 songs that we had on last summer, we're going to have again in the album, because we never applied them to anything, so I have those 3 songs, and then we're going to apply them to the 10 others.
And it's about what? This?
The theme of it is basically living in the Keys, and more often than not, though not all the time, it's mostly focused on Key West, because that's where I live. But I've also spent years in the Keys. So
how did this all come about?
The Keys have always been a really good inspiration for me in writing, and I don't go out to write a song. I'm just plunking on the guitar, and all of a sudden something sounds good. Next thing I know, I'm writing a song. And the Keys have always been paramount in the inspiration for me. I'll start plunking away, all of a sudden something, I'll be thinking about the keys, and a song comes from out of the blue.
Literally,
out of the blue. That's how I write.
Not like what those seagulls are going to drop on you in a minute, huh?
It's kind of similar.
What kind of genre does this album fall into?
It's going to be a wide variety. I call my music conk rock.
Conk rock, not trop rock?
Well, it has trop rock in it, but it has things that trop rock doesn't have. You know, there's going to be a couple of songs that are going to be really funky, which I've never heard trop rock get funky before. And
true.
This is going to have funky stuff, and it's also going to... My music also, a lot of the trop rock that I hear is very nice, but it's very smooth and everything. My stuff has a bit of an edge to it.
Well, we like that.
Yeah, well, I that's what I am.
Thus,
like that song Garrison Bite that I wrote on your boat.
Yeah.
Yeah, that song has a serious edge to it.
Literally written at Garrison Bite.
It was written in Garrison Bite. And
looking
it was
out the back
on,
door.
It was written on your boat.
So when did you start writing?
The first, one of the songs I have on it, which is another funky song, by the way, is a song I wrote in 1997. Although I didn't, at that point, plan it for the album. It's going to be on the album. The name of that song is called Mile Zero.
I love that song.
You edit, yeah, because you helped me out with the demo that we did.
One of my favorites. I think it was a Thanksgiving night where you tricked me into coming over for dinner.
Yes.
And then...
Then we hired you to... We Shanghai'd you.
Shanghai'd.
Into recording it for Jackson and myself.
Probably where the title song came from that night after a lot of turkey. So when do you hope to have it completed? And I know this answer. As soon as possible.
Yeah, well, Danny is away.
And the cats will play.
Yeah, so when he gets back from his vacation, which will be in early October, we're going to do the recording then. And we're going to try our best to have it out for Meeting of the Minds.
All the best from Key West. Said goodbye to New Jersey, New York too. Said goodbye to old Cape Cod, we'll see you soon. Turned the wheel around and I pointed it south, back to my little island.
The MySpace is myspace.com/chrismusicnow.